It has been observed that several treatable animal diseases are no longer responding to the same antimicrobials that were initially effective in treating them. This trend, in which disease-causing microorganisms resist the effects of drugs that they were initially susceptible to, is raising concern to the public, animal and environmental health. Pizombo Sinje is an urban farmer in Wakiso District who started his journey as a pasture farmer and silage stockist, started his farm in 2016 after buying the land. He started with pastures production and preservation to help farmers feed their animals well.
Someone buys a cow, it's looking well, but after 2 months, because he's not trained well, and the cow becomes emaciated and he loses the cow. So for us, joining the farming, we're entering to help those people by how to feed cows. And we started by feeding. We started by telling people the good pastures, how to make hay, how to make silage.
Having been raised from cattle keeping at home, Businja says he attends to small health care for his cattle with guidance from a veterinary doctor in his home. Businja stressed that Uganda is faced with a challenge of limited number of veterinary doctors, especially in far-reaching areas.
Most of the cows, by the way, they normally do sick as a result of poor feeding. Okay, poor feeding. You find you're feeding your cows dignified pastures which are not good, or you just go near the road and cut everything, and it comes with diseases, they come with different ticks and all that, and then they affect your cow. So here, as you're going to see, we prevented that by feeding our cows good food.
Businja has, however, advised fellow farmers to always seek advice from specialists, especially attempting to treat animals.
There is a case I mastered last year when someone was treating ECF, okay? Someone was treating ECF when actually a cow has anaplasmosis. So he was using the medicine for treating ECF, and yet the cow has another disease. He ended up by losing the cow, and that was not good, okay? That is the reason, that is the bad thing of treating instead of treating. Since he had called the doctor, maybe he wouldn't have lost the cows.
Dr. Lawrence Mogisha, a lecturer at Makerere University in the College of Veterinary, says that like other living things, animals get infected with fungal, viral and bacterial infections, but with wrong treatments, effects are carried on to humans through animal products like milk, meat, fertilizers and many more.
Once they start treating and they realize the animals are not responding well, they may end up dying. They don't want to lose money. Now they decide to sell the animals which are sick under treatment. That is another big risk, because now you're exposing human beings who are not there now to these antibiotics which have been used in treating the animals.
He noted that some farmers tend to self-prescribe medication to their animals, something that he has discouraged.
Now, in animals, you can also do a first aid, and like that, intervention, stop breeding, and so on, until you call the right professional to help you with the next step. But usually in husbandry practice, we use what we call prevention, prophylactic measures, whereby you can regard it to, if you vaccinate your birds, you are protecting them against diseases in the future.
He further discouraged the use of human medicine to treat animals.
Most of these antimicrobials, they are made from same classes of the drugs. When we look at pharmaceutical the ingredients, but they are formulated differently and packaged differently for different species. So the drugs packaged for animals are not supposed to be used in humans. The drugs packaged for humans are not supposed to be used in animals.
Dr. Andrew Kiwango, the Wakiso District Veterinary Officer, recommends the offering of first aid to animals under the instruction and guidance of a veterinary doctor.
When our animals get sick on the farm, what are we supposed to do? Number one is we contact our veterinary surgeon to advise us on what to do. Number two is that we tell our veterinary doctor the clinical history, what signs is the animal presenting with, so that identifies the best course of treatment. And the veterinary surgeon will be able to pick samples from your animals, appropriate samples, which you will deliver to the laboratory.
He further explains the interventions done to mitigate farmers prescribing drugs to treat animals.
As public vets, we continue to look for veterinary station. We call out regular farmer sensitizations. We sensitize farmers on the dangers of self-prescription in animal health to ensure that farmers understand the dangers that are in treating animals without professional knowledge.
To limit the development of resistance for the benefit of animals and public health, the European Medicine Agency is promoting a prudent use of antimicrobials in animals and is engaged in numerous activities to address the threat arising from the use of medically important antimicrobials in food-producing animals. Sharon Navasidie for the news.